Prime Minister designate Narendra Modi is all set to take oath as the Prime Minister of the India for the third consecutive time today. Before the swearing in ceremony, Modi visited Rajghat and paid his tribute to Mahatma Gandhi, the father of the nation. Then he paid homage to former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee at Sadaiv Atal as well. He also paid tributes to bravehearts at the National War Memorial. The new NDA cabinet swearing in ceremony is scheduled to take place today at the Rashtrapati Bhavan amid multi-layered security. Bangladesh Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina and Seychelles Vice President Ahmed Afif have arrived in India already to attend Modi's swearing-in ceremony today. The event is also expected to witness the presence of leaders from Maldives, Sri Lanka, Bhutan, Nepal and Mauritius as part of India's neighborhood first policy.
Well,
watching the match?
I have not been invited to the swearing in any way, so I'll be watching the match.
Thank you.
पहले पहली बार विधायक सीधे मुख्यमंत्री थे, दूसरी बार विधायक फिर मुख्यमंत्री थे, तीसरी बार विधायक फिर मुख्यमंत्री और पूर्ण बहुमत के साथ। फिर जब मध्यप्रदेश देश में आए तो पहली बार पूर्ण बहुमत की सरकार, दूसरी बार पूर्ण बहुमत की सरकार, ये भी सब रिकॉर्ड है। और अब की बार एनडीए की पूर्ण बहुमत के साथ सरकार है तो सौभाग्य की बात है। और मोदी जी है तो मुमकिन है, यह लोग कहते हैं मोदी है तो मुमकिन है, एनडीए मुमकिन है। इसलिए निश्चित रूप से मैं शुभकामना देता हूँ।
All right, so we'll be tracking all the latest updates straight from the ground. Early this morning, we already told you the itinerary of Prime Minister, how he first visited to pay his regards to the father of the nation. He visited Rajghat, then paid tribute to Mahatma Gandhi. Then he went on to Sadaiv Atal to pay homage to former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee as well. He also paid tributes to the brave hearts who lost their life while protecting the nation at the National War Memorial. Today is going to be a mega event. We are expecting people from all walks of life who have contributed to the progress of our country attending the mega oath ceremony of Modi 3.0 cabinet. This time around, it's going to be a whole new different cabinet that we'll be looking at. According to the sources, the words that we have been receiving are the major rejects that are likely to happen in the Modi 3.0 cabinet. We have CNN News 18's Payal Mehta back with us on the broadcast to walk us through all the latest update that she has received from her sources. Payal, a very good morning to you. Certainly a big day. It's the D-Day today. Modi 3.0 is going to come back with different faces this time. Tell us everything that you have received from your sources so far.
Well, Mr. Chandrasekhar, who's a sitting member of parliament, has just won the election from Guntur. He's all set to become the Minister of State from the TDP quota. Remember, he has replaced Mr. Jay Galla, who was a two-time member of parliament, because Jay Galla decided to sit out of these elections for business reasons as well. But Mr. Chandrasekhar is a young candidate that the TDP has put up to become the Minister of State. He is in fact the richest MP in Andhra Pradesh with a declared income of 5,650 crores. And he is a very, very enterprising MP as well. And of course, as far as the TDP's quota for the cabinet minister is concerned, we've broken this yesterday itself, given the fact that Ram Mohan Naidu is one of the most senior leaders in that ranks. Remember, Ram Mohan Naidu is a third time MP this time around. He's the youngest MP to ever become a union minister. That's what his office has confirmed, saying that he's all of 36 years old. He has been somebody who has stood the storm. Remember when YSR Congress was dominating the proceedings as far as the anger against TDP was concerned, Ram Mohan Naidu decided to still hold fort and stayed with Chandrababu Naidu, you know, for the longest time, even though some of his party colleagues decided to actually go ahead and join the YSR Congress. But Ram Mohan Naidu stood there. His father, Mr. Eranna Naidu, was one of the tallest leaders of the TDP. It has been somebody, he has been somebody who's actually been a former union minister as well. So obviously, the TDP boss here rewarding Ram Mohan Naidu for his loyalty and also for his withstanding the storm that the TDP went through.
Definitely. So that's the big breaking news of the hour, ladies and gentlemen, that our colleague Payal Mehta has just given to us, that TDP has already confirmed its two names for the cabinet post, which is Ram Mohan Naidu and Chandrasekhar Premasani as well. They have given out this confirmation on their social media profiles as well. Payal, now coming back to you and talking about the functions that are going to transpire today and how exactly the NDA 3.0 is going to function further for the upcoming 5 years. How difficult or not so difficult is it going to be for Narendra Modi?
Well, Narendra Modi has withstood all the challenges in his life. You know, when he became the chief minister in 2001, after that you saw the episode pan out of the Godhra riots in 2002. Despite that, he was able to be in power, withstand all the storm, withstand all the criticism, face the SIT inquiry, etc., and come clean. And then probably he was there till 2014, till national calling came for him. And from 2014, you know, he had inherited a government which was actually had policy paralysis, was ridden with scams as well. But Prime Minister Modi came with a mission that he would, in fact, take the India growth story forward. That is exactly what we've seen over the last 10 years. He has worked for every strata of society, every section of society. BJP became a party to reckon with, even in the uncharted territories. For example, in the Northeast, BJP became a force to reckon with. BJP, in fact, formed a government in the state of Tripura after 25 years of left rule. BJP was able to come from 2 MPs, you know, in 2014 to 18 MPs in 2019, and then 11 plus MPs now in Bengal as well. And of course, for the first time in the last many decades, BJP has been able to, you know, make sure that there was exit for the BJP government, and BJP's been able to form government. So many, many things that Prime Minister Narendra Modi has been capable of doing, has been speaking about doing as well. And that is something which every BJP karyakarta takes a lot of pride in, because people say Modi hai to mumkin hai, and Modi ki guarantee is something the BJP has been seeking its votes in on the last election itself.
Definitely, Payal. Also, according to the protocols, all of those who will be taking oaths today are likely to get the invitation calls from today onwards. All right, Payal, we request you to please stay with us. We have CNN News 18's Aman Sharma also back with us on the broadcast. Aman, what are the latest updates that you have first picked up from your sources? What can be expected from today's functions?
Well, Sakshi, if we speak of the Union Council of Ministers, obviously it's a BJP loves to keep everything very, very closely guarded. And you know, I am sure that there will be some big surprises today in the Union Council list, especially from the BJP side, because one must remember almost 20 ministers have lost in these elections. So obviously there will be new faces which we could see also in some senior you know, ministries. We could see some new faces coming up. BJP has some senior faces which have won in these Lok Sabha elections, who are not at the center right now. I can tell you the name of maybe Shivraj Singh Chauhan, who's said to be a front runner for a cabinet post in the center now. Mr. Manohar Lal Khattar, the former chief minister of Haryana. Baswiraj Bommai, the former chief minister of Karnataka of the BJP. Biplab Deb, the former Tripura chief minister. All these names from the BJP camp are also doing the rounds now for senior minister positions in the government, because, you know, there is a gap here, because, as I said, 20 ministers have lost in these elections. From the alliance side, what we are hearing since, what we are reporting since yesterday, and now, you know, that story is getting picked up everywhere else, that nearly 12 to 15 berths in the Union Council of Ministers could be going to the allies, especially the JDU, the TDP. The JDU isn't running for the TDP, if I start off with, isn't running for a full cabinet ministry post and an MOS post. The names which we are reporting since yesterday, K. Ram Mohan Naidu, the three-time MP from Srikulam, a close confidant of Chandrababu Naidu, is in the running for the cabinet post. There's Chandrasekhar Pemmasani, whose name Payal was also just mentioning, in the running for the post of the Minister of State from the JDU, which has 12 seats, also one cabinet, one MOS is likely. Mr. Lalan Singh, a senior leader and, you know, and close aide of Nitesh Kumar, or Mr. Sanjay Jha, one of the two, I think, could make it to the Council of Ministers. And the MOS post could go to Ramnath Thakur, the son of Karpuri Thakur, who's Ramnath Thakur has been a JDU leader, is a JDU leader even currently, and that could be very, very you know, big symbolically also for the government. These are the names from the JDU which are doing the rounds. The LJP and the RLD and the Shiv Sena all could get one cabinet minister post. So Jayant Chaudhary, Chirag Paswan, Mr. Shinde's party, Srirang Barne or Pratap Rao Jadhav could make the cut. S.P. Kumaraswamy from the JDU could become a union minister. From the NCP, the toss-up is between Praful Patel or Sunil Tatkare, the names which are doing the rounds. Janasena, it is not decided yet who will be making the cut from Janasena, or if Janasena will become a part of the Central Union Council of Ministers or not, because Mr. Pavan Kalyan is in the running to become the Deputy Chief Minister in Andhra Pradesh as well. There are also seems to be almost, you know, certainty that from Apna Dal, Anupriya Patel could become a minister. She's already a minister. A woman face could be a part of the Council of Ministers. Talk about Jatin Ram Manjhi also being in the running. So all these speculations actually are doing the round. We'll only know, of course, by late afternoon what is the final list. But this seems to be the contours of the Modi 3.0 government, which will get sworn in today along with the Prime Minister and the Council of Ministers.
Right, Aman, please stay with us. A series of reporters are joining us straight from the ground to bring us and all of our viewers all the latest updates that they have picked up as far as the big oath taking ceremony is concerned. We have Arun Dhanta joining us live. We have Shireen Elizabeth as well as our senior editor Pallavi Ghosh also joining us on the broadcast. Pallavi, first coming to you, the quick word coming in straight from the opposition. We heard what Shashi Tharoor had to say. He said, I have not been served with the invitation. I'm going to watch the match. Rather, what's the word coming in from opposition? Have any of them received any invitation yet?
See, there's a protocol which is in place. So I remember going by the last time, it is the party Congress president who are invited. And of course, I remember Sonia Gandhi was there. She was a UPA chairperson. Rahul Gandhi was also invited. And they were all sitting in the front row. As of now, none of them have got an invite. But, you know, this is a procedural process. I'm sure they are going to get it within the next 1 hour or so. The Trinamool Congress has made it very clear, come what may, they are not going to be attending the oath. As far as the Congress goes, well, I think the indication came in from it yesterday when Jairam Ramesh says that we don't think he has a mandate to be the Prime Minister. So what's the point of attending this oath? We are waiting to see when we get that invite. As of now, what we have been reporting is that most of the India Front parties are against the idea of attending the oath ceremony because Sakshi, they feel that if you are designating him as a non-prime minister, then why do you take part in the government process in his oath ceremony? It's a very, very bad start to the coalition politics and also to the opposition and the government kind of nuances. It just goes on to show that what is going to be the scene inside the parliament. You know, you may have your disagreements. You may not think he deserves to be the PM, but he is taking oath as a prime minister. He heads the government. He's going to be a part and head of that parliament where you're going to be sitting in opposition. So the maryada, the garima, the prestige which that post occupies, you are going to negate it right from the past, not attending the oath. It's not a very good start to what could have been a healthy kind of interaction inside the parliament. So things as they stand now, confrontation from day one.
Definitely. And he's not just yours and mine, Prime Minister. He's going to be opposition's Prime Minister as well. Shireen continues to stay with us on the broadcast. Shireen, tell us the latest that you have received from the ground as far as the excitement on the ground is also concerned. Please walk us through that.
Well, it is too early for the excitement, I believe, because right now I'm standing right outside Jaydev Galla's residence where Chandrababu Naidu is also staying. And on my way there, the security is clearly beefed up and there is a lot of people who are in fact around the India Gate. So it is going to be a big day as far as Prime Minister is going to take oath for the third time. Now, when we talk about Chandrababu Naidu, it's a big day for him as well, but his work is not finished here. After the Prime Minister's oath, he has to take oath as the Chief Minister on 12th June. So that is the, we have seen for past few days, the hectic parlays that has been going on between the BJP and its NDA allies. And finally, some pictures are getting clearer. We have seen how Chandrababu Naidu is going to get at least two ministerial berths. One is Dr. Chandrasekhar and the other is Ram Mohan Naidu. So these two people are going to be the face of the TDP in the NDA alliance in the central government. Apart from that, we are also being told is that there is going to be, you know, a demand that will be made by Chandrababu Naidu as far as the package is concerned, funds are concerned, because the next 5 years, the plan of Chandrababu Naidu is to make sure that the major development works get done in the state so that when the election comes, he gets another term. So that is the plan with which Chandrababu Naidu is supporting Prime Minister. We have seen how both Chandrababu Naidu and Nitish Kumar has confirmed that they will be staying with Prime Minister, will be staying in NDA itself. Of course, the opposition is going to closely watch that whether there will in fact be a time when they could actually make a move, because they have been saying that they are not going to rule out no confidence motion in the future. But all that keeping aside, today is the big day when for the third time Prime Minister is going to take oath as Narendra Modi is going to take oath as the Prime Minister.
Definitely. As Shireen correctly mentioned, it's too early to see any kind of activity transpiring there on the ground. But Prime Minister-elect Narendra Modi is already up and he has already paid his respect to Mahatma Gandhi, to late Atal Bihari Vajpayee, as well as all of those who lost their life while protecting the nation. Arun also continues to stay with us on the broadcast. We have been talking to him since morning. Arun, now tell us a little bit about the SAARC leaders who are going to be there at the event today. Because yesterday, Sheikh Hasina, we saw her coming in and getting a warm welcome. In India, of course, she has come for the big event today. About all of those leaders, have they come? When exactly? Who will be coming?
Well, of course, not only the foreign dignitaries, but of course, people from our country, from different walks of life, they will also be participating in this oath-taking ceremony of Prime Minister-designate Narendra Modi. And in fact, they are ensuring that this event is not only for the VIP and VVIPs, and therefore the people like sanitation workers who are involved in the Central Vista project, the workers, they will also be there, transgender sanitation worker and the rat miners who in fact helped in rescue of 41 people in Uttarakhand, and all the people who have got benefit from the central government schemes, those beneficiaries will also be part of it. Of course, there will be other prominent people from different walks of life who will be participating in this oath-taking ceremony. And the culture, of course, which in 2014 started by Narendra Modi when he invited the SAARC leaders for his first oath-taking ceremony, and that was followed by in 2019. And similarly, this time around, we are seeing SAARC nations becoming part of the oath-taking ceremony of Prime Minister-designate Narendra Modi. So I think there are many delegates who have already arrived here yesterday, and some of them who are remaining, they will be reaching here in Delhi today, and therefore accordingly all the arrangements have been made for them. All the foreign dignitaries who will be arriving at Indira Gandhi International Airport, how they would be reaching to the hotel, so all those arrangements have been made so that they don't face any difficulty while traveling from airport to their respective hotels. And then of course in the evening, 7:15 is the time when the oath taking ceremony will begin, and we are told that more than 7,000 people will be attending this. All the preparations are done, invites have been given to all those people who would be participating in this oath ceremony. So it's a very significant and a historic day today.
Right, also, and according to the sources, a separate designated route has also been given for the arrival of all those leaders, looking at the security of them as well. We have got some breaking inputs now coming in straight for that. We are learning that Prime Minister can actually call the members who will be joining the cabinet for a tea today, right before the oath-taking ceremony as well. So that's the big and crucial update. We can in fact get some of the details about those who will be joining the cabinet as well. Payal continues to stay with us on the broadcast with more details. Payal, so can we actually look at some of the details coming out from that tea that Prime Minister has invited all the cabinet members to?
Well, of course, Sakshi, this happens every time that the government is sworn in. It has at least happened over the last two terms that the government was being sworn in. Various leaders start getting calls from early in the morning. For example, at 10:30, either the BJP president or either the Prime Minister himself in case of a senior leader. And obviously, and sometimes B.L. Santosh, etc., they start making these calls and tell leaders to be there. And already most of the leaders have been told to be in Delhi, and those people who are going to be coming, ministers are told to in fact come to the Prime Minister's residence for a cup of tea as well. So that is when the Prime Minister hosts them for a cup of tea, and they have a brief discussion in place. Obviously, at that point in time, nobody knows what their portfolio will be, and nobody knows whether they're going to become cabinet ministers or MOS. That's a bit of a suspense even then. But you know, the moment the leaders start getting a call, they do understand they're going to be part of Modi government as well. So that's been happening. And this time also, we can expect something like this to also happen, because this has been the protocol of the last 10 years as well. So, you know, around 10:30, you should start expecting people to get calls and being told that they're going to be part of the Modi cabinet.
Definitely. Payal, please stay with us. We've got some more breaking input now coming in. These are emerging straight from the Maharashtra. And as far as the cabinet of 3.0 is concerned, the top NDA sources have revealed to CNN News 18 that NCP as well as Sena will get one berth each only. So earlier we were listening at a couple of names emerging from Maharashtra as far as the Ministry of States as well as cabinet positions being given to them. This is the latest word from the NDA sources that they have informed CNN News 18 that in fact NCP and Sena are only going to get one berth each. Payal continues to stay with us on the broadcast over this input as well. Payal, please help us put that into perspective for our viewers. So many names, but one berth each.
Now, for many opposition parties who are going to be really surprised that none of these allies have actually come out with and made any demands. they basically say that they trust the captain of the ship, they trust Prime Minister Narendra Modi to be able to do a fair job for everybody and to keep everybody on the same page as well. So that's the reason, because NCP just has one winning candidate and Shiv Sena has one, she has won many more seats than the NCP. Both of these parties are going to get one berth each. Now, we do not really know whether both of them are going to be cabinet or both of them are going to be MOS as well. But we do understand that Mr. Praful Patel, whose name has been doing the rounds, he's been saying very clearly that he's not in the reckoning. And in fact, Sunil Sarkar, the winning candidate from the NCP, probably could be in the running for a post in the centre. Also, you know, Ekna Shinde has made it very, very clear that his son will not become a minister because he does not want to talk about, you know, family rule. He doesn't want to talk about dynastic rules. But he basically wants to reward the topmost leadership of the party. In fact, the senior most leadership of the party. So whether it is Mr. Barner or it's going to be, Pratap Jadhav, that remains to be seen. But it's very, very clear from the part of the Shiv Sena. And we were able to speak to Mr. Ekna Shinde also, you know, the other day. And he said very clearly that my son will not become a minister. Shrikant himself has gone out and told people that he's not keen on becoming a minister because that decision has been left to his father. So all the political parties, even the TDP, has said that they did not make any demands. They just left it to Prime Minister Narendra Modi. And whatever needs to be done will be done. But most importantly, the TDP wants the centre's handholding to in fact build up the state again because they feel the state has been completely in doldrums over the last 5 years.
In fact, we'll get more clarity over the candidates through the day. It's just the beginning, ladies and gentlemen. We are getting all the fiery updates that we are receiving from our sources. Another breaking news now coming in. This is the word that we are receiving, say, from our TDP sources. They have also told CNN News 18 that one cabinet and one ministry of state has been allotted to TDP. Payal continues to stay with us on the broadcast. Earlier, Payal, we were talking about one cabinet berth definitely being given to the TDP, but two ministry of states. Now, the word that we have received from our sources is that one cabinet as well as one ministry of state is going to be given to TDP. More words.
Yes, of course. Ram Mohan Naidu has been the senior most leader in the ranking. He's been somebody who's withstood the entire YSR storm and the YSR attack on the TDP. He's been there throughout with Chandrababu Naidu. Given the fact that his father was a very close aide of Chandrababu Naidu, his father was one of the tallest leaders and was also a former union minister. You know, so the opposition parties try to break many leaders, but they are not able to break Ram Mohan Naidu, and this is his third term. So the party has decided to reward him. The party leadership has decided to reward him with a cabinet berth. As far as Mr. Chandrasekhar is concerned, Mr. Chandrasekhar has just taken just won his first election from Guntur. And you can see that, you know, he was congratulated by Mr. Jay Galla, who is a sitting member of parliament from Guntur, but is sitting out this election as well. So those two confirmations come from the TDP itself, essentially telling you that, yeah, these are the two names that are going to be taking oath today on the TDP quota. And Ram Mohan Naidu, being the youngest union minister, is going to send a benchmark for itself because he has been somebody who's been raising the issues of the Andhra Pradesh state, raising the issues of the lack of funds as far as the state is concerned. Unfulfilled promise by the centre, also something that he has been raising. But most importantly, the TDP is also looking at handholding for the centre so that they can actually rebuild their state.
So the top updates that we have received from our sources so far and the information that has been brought in by my colleague Payal Mehta is that the NCP is going to get one berth, Sena is going to get one berth, and TDP sources in fact have went on to tell CNN News 18 that one cabinet as well as one ministry of state has been allotted to TDP as well. Earlier we were listening to a lot of names coming out, but remember Chandrababu Naidu made it very clear during the press conference while extending support to Prime Minister-elect Narendra Modi that he is pretty much going to stay with the NDA. He is going to be extending his support to the NDA, and what he is actually eyeing at is a majority of the funds for Andhra Pradesh as well as the capital Amravati also. That's the crucial word that Chandrababu Naidu at the very beginning while extending his support towards Prime Minister designate Narendra Modi cleared to the press. Time for a quick commercial break here on